Today we're going to be talking about the Facebook coin, the Libra coin, and you know, pretty much going down that rabbit hole and trying to figure out if this new coin is that new SDR, aka that NWO New World Currency type of thing that we've been hearing about for a while. I mean, something's got to replace the dollar, so why not Zuckbucks? Anyways, you want to know more? Just stay tuned for more. I got to come up with a better catchphrase. This is fucking just... Yeah, I know, it's a crazy idea. It's a crazy, you know, theory. In fact, you know, you might even call it a conspiracy theory. But it doesn't matter. Hey, I mean, you know, that's what we're going to be talking about this. And, you know, we're going to see if we can figure this out, okay? We've already had a conversation, and I don't know. I just figured I'm going to share it with everybody else because I think it's pretty awesome, right? Well, I bet you're kind of wondering what the hell me and Lambo were talking about. Well, you know, me and Lambo were literally talking about the fact that is the lighting working there? The other day, I was actually watching some other crypto YouTuber out there. It was Naomi Brockwell, and she was having a discussion with somebody on her panel. And they were literally talking about the fact that, well, he was bringing up the fact that, hey, you know, it wouldn't be so far-fetched to think that this whole Facebook coin is just an attempt by the bankers, an attempt by, you know, the people in power to, you know, smoothly transition from the dollar to a brand new currency, a brand new world currency. And, you know, when he brought that up, I was like, of course, you know, why didn't I think of that? You know, why wasn't that something that popped in my head? And so, you know, that's what gave me the inspiration to do today's episode. And that's what we're going to be talking about today. We're going to be talking about exactly that. And so let's just break that down real quick. All right. We all know that Facebook was funded by the U.S. government. Okay, now we're not going to divulge too much and go too deep into that rabbit hole. If you guys want to know more information, you guys already know what I'm going to tell you. Go find out yourself. But for the most part, most of us are already fully aware that most of these big tech companies, whether it's Google or Amazon, and yes, even Facebook, were all created by the U.S. government. The CIA and so on and so forth, you know, already had a program like Facebook in place. And all of a sudden, I forgot when, but literally the day that Facebook went live for the first day ever, back when it was in the college days, you know, when Zuckerberg was still in his dorm room, well, that same day was also the same day that the CIA program that was literally doing the same thing that Facebook is doing ended. So, yeah, you make up, you know, what you... And plus, you know, there's so many more other things that link both of these entities straight together. You know, literally the U.S. government funding Facebook and its development and its growth. And again, that's not what we're going to be here talking about or exploring. Now, as you guys already know, right now, Facebook is public enemy number one. And specifically within the US and places like Europe, you know, Facebook is public enemy number one. And, you know, even though right now the governments or central banks should be public enemy number one, in a lot of places, Facebook is taking the lead. And Facebook is just a corporation. So, you know, again, you know, we can easily see how, you know, we're being manipulated into, you know, keep, you know, don't look over here, but look over here. So, you know, don't look at the government, don't look at the central banks, don't look at what's really going on. But instead, let's focus on Facebook and let's focus on what they're doing over here and how they're manipulating you through whatever the fuck they're doing over here. And they're the bad guys. So right now in this stage of the propaganda, most of the people already, you know, consider Facebook public enemy number one. And not only do they consider Facebook public enemy number one, but, you know, most of them, you know, even if they use it and love it, they're very, very, you know, worry, you know, they're very careful around Facebook and what they do around Facebook nowadays for the most part. But I digress. A few months ago or a while ago, Facebook was in front of the U.S. government, you know, literally you know, standing trial because of the privacy issues and everything that had to do with privacy. And you guys will remember, you know, Zuckerberg drinking the water like a robot and all these things. And in fact, as of a couple days ago, or today, or whenever the hell you're watching this, you know, Zuckerberg and Facebook, they just got hit by some crazy fine. I think it was like $5 billion, you know, a fine that they have to pay the U.S. government for, you know, selling people's information and, you know, all that data mining that they've been doing. All right. So again, you know, just reestablishing the fact that Facebook is public enemy number one, and that even though the government sucks, remember, this is the narrative that they're trying to push on you guys, that even though this government sucks, it doesn't matter because, you know, they don't suck as much as Facebook. And look, the government has your back because they're going after Facebook, you know, as they do these horrible things. Look at how harsh they're being on Facebook. You know, that's a huge ass fine. And then not only that, but the minute that Facebook announced their Libra coin white paper, because again, that's all they've done. You know, all Facebook's done is said, hey, we're gonna create a cryptocurrency, which, by the way, it's not a real cryptocurrency, it's not really a blockchain, but that's not what we're talking about here. But they said, hey, we're gonna create our own cryptocurrency, and then literally the minute, the day after they said that, you know, we're looking at, you know, all these people in US government and other governments around the world cracking down and coming down on hard on Facebook and demanding that they stop, that they don't do this, and so on and so forth. So again, you know, the government is reminding you, look, Facebook is public enemy number one, and yes, even though the government sucks, look, we're trying to protect you, we're on top of this, we're going after Facebook, we're not letting them do this, you know, even though there's other reasons, okay, why these governments and banks are really trying to stop Facebook and the Libra coin. You know, that's not, you know, what they're telling you. They're just letting you know that, hey, look, Facebook is evil, and we don't want them to have control of your money. You know, they already got control of your data. They can't do this. And if they do have control of your money, then we got to make sure that they go through all the hoops and all the rules and regulations. And we're going to create even more hoops and rules and regulations for them to follow to make sure that you're safe. So you're welcome. You know, that's what the government's kind of telling you right now. But again, if you know, you know, how this novella, how this soap opera, how this whole thing really works, again, they are just, you know, playing you like a fiddle, or playing most people out there like a fiddle. Because why, you know, they're making, you know, Facebook public enemy number one, then they're coming in, they're stepping in and saying, hey, look, we're gonna fix this. And then once they fix it and say, okay, now it's allowed to be, to function as a world currency, again, you know, they, the US government, the central banks would have literally their whole foot into this, in this pie. You know, that's really my thought on what's going on right now, because as soon as I started reading the white paper and we started looking into, you know, the Facebook coin, you know, we realized very quickly that this is just, you know, another version of the SDR. And by the way, if you guys don't know what the SDR is, I'm gonna put a little picture here. But what the SDR is just basically a basket of currencies, okay? And they create a brand new currency that gets its value from all these other currencies, okay? And that is the world currency that, you know, they are using, as opposed to the dollar, okay? Or that's the whole point. And as we all know, and we discuss on this channel all the freaking time, that the dollar is, you know, kaput. The dollar's gonna die, it's dead. It's gonna, you know, the petrol dollar, all of these things, you know, even, again, you know, we're all, the only thing that we don't agree on is when it's gonna die and crash. But at the end of the day, it's happening. It's on its way to, you know, disappearing off the face of the earth. And we all also know who controls the dollar, who creates the dollar, and it's the central banks. It's not necessarily the government. The Federal Reserve is a private company, and they give the money to the U.S. government. So, if a private company already is in control of the U.S. dollar, and in fact the main reserve currency of the world at the moment, then what makes you think that, you know, they wouldn't want another corporation to blatantly also, you know, own the next currency coming up? Which again, that's what's happening with Facebook. You know, Facebook is gonna derive Facebook is going to derive its value from all a basket of currencies. You know, everything from the dollar to the euro and everything, and everybody else that wants to participate within this, Libra coin or whatever. And yeah, you know, just like an SDR, you know, there might be more less dollars and there might be more euros and there might be and all that stuff. So, you know, all that is stuff that we got to all take into consideration, because again, with the death of the dollar, the death of the euro, the hyperinflation that we have yet to see, and all of these other, you know, banking nightmares that are coming down the pike, you know, something like a Libra coin would be the perfect vehicle for these banks, you know, to funnel all their money into and continue this charade for even longer than we even anticipated. Remember, we're in the end game right now. We're at the end of this cycle, you know, this monetary cycle, you know, this long monetary cycle that's been about 100 years. And it's going to, and you know, this one is a little different because we got things like computers, you know, we have other things like, you know, derivatives, you know, we got so many other things that, you know, we got negative interest rates. We have so many things that we've never had in the history of banking ever before. So, you know, just with the advent of computers and the use of computers, you know, they're going to really extend this even further than any other currency has ever been around for, I think, you know what I mean, in the history of humanity. And that's just it. Now, you know, we all know that most of these currencies last around 100 to 125, 150 years, something like that. And, you know, we're about at the 100-year mark still, you know what I mean? So we still got a ways to go, I think. And who knows if it's going to be another 25 to 50 years. Maybe not. Maybe I think it's going to be a lot less. But all I'm saying is that we still have a long ways to go. And if all of a sudden, you know, something like a Libra coin gets implemented and it gets used for like a decade, I mean, think about it. You know, that's only going to keep exacerbating, you know, keep these things like the dollar and the euro and all these other currencies alive and well for a very long time. And we might not even realize, you know, these major gains with things like gold and silver. Now, we will realize, you know, major gains with Bitcoin and other, a few handful of other cryptocurrencies. But for the most part, you know, this is going to take a lot longer than we expect. I mean, just because of a million reasons. And, you know, honestly, this whole Facebook being the new SDR, being, you know, the new world currency, it really doesn't seem that far-fetched. Because if, you know, the deeper we go down this rabbit hole, you know, there's everyone that's watching right now, you guys are all at different levels of going down the rabbit hole. But for most of you guys that are really deep down the rabbit hole, you know, this whole idea that, you know, Facebook was created by the bankers a very long time ago in anticipation for this moment and beyond, I mean, you know, it's not that far-fetched. And again, maybe they weren't thinking that far ahead. You know, they were just thinking of creating Facebook, you know, for the data and, you know, the new 1994 new Orwellian world that we're living in. But, you know, as time has progressed and they have grown themselves and the technology has grown and everything is where it's at now, you know, now the whole idea of them implementing a new world currency and putting it through Facebook doesn't seem that far-fetched. And again, guys, you know, this could just be a stepping stone, you know, to, you know, them implementing this and then other, you know, countries, you know, start making their own, you know, cryptocurrencies, which are not real cryptocurrencies, you know, like the Fed coin, like Venezuela has the petro, Russia wants to create their own, Iran, and all these countries are doing that. And so, you know, we're moving into a very, very interesting new world in which, you know, the central banks, as we know them, are losing their power, and they are not going to be the central banks of the future, if we even have central banks in the future. Now, I do think that we're going to have central banks and central banking for a very long time. They're still going to be around for a while, like for reals. You know what I mean? Like at least another like 20, 25 years. It's just a fact. Maybe longer. But as time progresses and we have less and less use for them, they're going to disappear. Okay, you got to remember that 20 years, this disappears like that. Even though it's 2019, I, in a weird way, I almost feel like it's 1999. I know, whatever. But I know a lot of you guys, especially in my age group, feel the same. And, you know, 20 years isn't really not that long. It really isn't. 25 years is not that long. And as we know, what has happened in just the last 20 to 25 years? 25 years ago, people were barely online, barely using America Online to get online and chat with people. Okay? The fucking iPhone was only invented like, what, 10 years ago, 15 years ago? And so on and so forth. So, I mean, things just, all right? And we already know where technology sits today and where we're going and all these other things. And, you know, this is all just part of the bigger picture. You know, the U.S. government, the central banks, you know, have been wanting a new world digital currency for, again, a very long time, since the inception of the internet. So this is nothing new. And they have gotten pretty close to having a monopoly, or to have, you know, this central banking system in which, you know, they exclude who they want to exclude and include who they want to include. We got pretty close to, you know, the point of no return, but thank God that we have something like Bitcoin that has allowed people to remain on the grid, to remain, you know, part of society and not be completely excluded from the system because of banking. And again, you know, as banking now has, you know, starting to become obsolete, and especially in third world countries where people are realizing that it's a lot better to use crypto than banking, period, because first of all, they don't even trust a bank, and they need, but they still need a bank, and then all of a sudden you're giving them the option to be their own bank. So, you know, they're already, you know, adopting this at, you know, record lightning speed. And so the banks themselves are, you know, coming to this, you know, hard realization that the reality is that they already, the solution the replacement for the current banking system is already here, and it's thriving, and it's alive and well, and it's only going to get bigger and better as time goes on. And so now the banking system is constantly struggling and trying to figure out a way in which to remain relevant forever. And we, the people, are trying to figure out a way in which to make them irrelevant and replace them with something that is better than the banking system, because that's the other thing too. And the only way that Bitcoin and crypto is ever going to replace the banking system is that it has to be better. And the thing is that even though Bitcoin and this crypto technology is still in its infancy, and yeah, it's still not quite as good as the banking system, well, the banking system is deteriorating so fast, and Bitcoin is, you know, kind of growing in its path, that it's already, you know, surpassing the banking system and better than in a lot of ways. So now it's all about the mass adoption and getting everyone around the world to eventually use it, which they will, because, you know, just like 10, 15 years ago, you know, most of the people on Earth didn't even have a cell phone, and now you go to the most remote village in Timbuktu, fucking Africa, or Asia, or Latin America, or wherever, and everybody's connected. Everybody has a cell phone. Everybody has technology. So it's the same thing. All right, we're already there. So more people have cell phones than they do have bank accounts around the world. And with that being said, we already know that, you know, people can have, you know, cryptocurrencies within their reach a lot faster than they can have a bank or a banking system. So again, going back to Libra, you know, trying to establish, you know, a new world currency, now you can see why the banking system is trying to figure out a way to stay relevant, and this would be the perfect way, because as most of you guys know, there's over 2 billion Facebook users on Earth. All right, so that's a lot. All right, and everybody has it on their phone. And now all of a sudden you're giving them a currency that they can interact with on a daily basis and even trade with their own local currency and all these other things, and even surpass the dollar in many ways. I mean, you know, it's just, this Pandora's box has been opened that it's, again, not gonna get closed. You know, we talk about this all the time. I've been saying that forever. Most of us in this space have been saying that forever. The Pandora's box is so open that it's the hinges. All right, it's off the hinges, and that's it. You know, we're here, and it's not gonna, I mean, it's either get on board now or else. All right, So, all right, guys, I think I'm going to wrap this one up right here. I think we went on pretty long. We had a pretty good little chat, little discussion about, you know, Facebook, the Libra coin, and everything that has to do with that. And, you know, what my theory is on this, okay? I actually do think that, you know, this whole Facebook Libra coin thing, it's coming from orders from above, if you know what I'm saying. And once a dollar actually does fall, and you know, all these currencies around the world start to fall, well, guess what? There's already going to be a replacement there's already going to be a replacement accessible to everyone at the palm of their hand, which is going to be that Facebook Libra coin. And again, a lot of people are, you know, as these currencies around the world start falling and deteriorating and disappearing, well, people are going to put their value in the Libra coin and eventually into Bitcoin. I mean, that's the idea, right? So again, my idea is for them to go into Bitcoin or go into something else and just use Libra as an intermediary to get there, okay? But as you guys already know, they're already out there saying that Facebook Libra coin is gonna be the coin. You know, again, as you're watching these government entities talk and grill Facebook, that's literally what they're bringing up. That's their fear that eventually people are gonna lose faith in the dollar or lose faith in all these other currencies and then put their faith in this Libra shit. Which is, you know, if you think about it, that's what they want, right? So again, we always got to be very, very careful and you know, how we listen to these individuals out there, because again, if we don't trust them, then we also got to, you know, we also got to like decipher everything that they're saying and know that they're all propagandists. They're all manipulating us one way or another. Now, sure, as you're watching a lot of these people talk about Bitcoin in Congress and all this other shit, you know, most of them don't know what the fuck they're talking about, but I'm sure once you, you know, really know what the hell's going on in the bigger scheme of things and you start listening to them not know what they're talking about, then all of a sudden you realize, oh shit, they actually do know what the fuck they're talking about. So again, guys, read between the lines, right? Guys, thank you so much for joining me today. Thank you so much for all the love I've been getting on, you know, all platforms, you know, because as you guys already know, I just literally launched joseartega.com about a week ago. It's been going great. A lot of signups, a lot of people, you know, sending me emails, a lot of love. As you guys already know, I've upgraded the website, you know, continuously. I've added things like expat services, which I'm gonna be talking about in a future episode. I've added things as well, you know, like, you know, I'm selling my prints. I'm also opening up a store to get the merchandise going and all that stuff. So, you know, it's all work in progress, all right? So just want to give a shout out to everyone out there for visiting. Want to give a shout out to everyone that has, you know, checks me out on all social medias, whether it's Instagram, you know, the Discord. Don't forget to join the Discord so you can join the conversation, you know, in between videos. And, you know, just again, you know, just thank you so much for, you know, following me and helping me and Lambo, you know, continue this journey together, helping educate everybody, all of you guys, about all kinds of things and so on and so forth. And, you know, a special shout out to all of you guys that are always sending me love, whether it's through PayPal, whether it's becoming a patron, you know, whether it's just watching an ad, okay, before or after one of my videos, regardless, you know what I mean? It all helps. It really does all help, okay? It all helps in every way possible, because even if you're just leaving a thumbs up, even if you're just leaving a comment, it helps spread the message. And as you guys already know, that's basically why I do all the things that I do, all right? That's why I'm trying to monetize in other ways, because I don't ever want to tarnish what I'm really doing here, which is, you know, just knowledge, just spreading knowledge, all right? And that's it. And there's no, you know, 22 book course like Tai Lopez tries to sell you. I mean, that's it. It's just me and Lambo for free. Oh, the only work you got to do is listen and then do some homework on your own. But anyways, just want to give a shout out to all of you guys out there. All you guys know exactly who you are. Thank you. Thank you so much for all the love, all the support, every single thing that you guys do on all fronts. And that's it. I'm ending it here. So don't forget to please like, please subscribe, please share, please hit that bell icon. And more importantly than anything else, you already know it. Stay awesome. And enjoy the rest of your day. Enjoy the rest of your week. And I'll see you guys mañana. You already know what's up. Peace.